This is a parsha of seeing. Its very name is for the opening pasuk. God appeared, Vayera Elav Hashem, evokes the imagery of seeing. And the theme is carried throughout the parsha. Four times in the Akedah story, for example, the root Vayera is repeated, beginning with Vayisa Avraham et Einav, Vayar. Avraham lifted up his eyes and saw. But there's one moment in the middle of these stories of seeing that is about losing our ability to see. It's a disturbing narrative. Lot welcomes guests into his home. A mob hears of this infraction and appear at the door. Lot, the consummate host, tries to quiet the mob by offering up his daughters. But Lot's guests, God's angels, come to the rescue and strike the angry mob with blindness. Hiku b'san beirim. And in the confusion, Lot and his family were able to escape from Sodom. I wonder about the plague of blindness. Why did the angels close their eyes as opposed to striking them with boils or cutting off their limbs? The hyper-focus on unseeing cannot be ignored. You see, there is something unbecoming that is going on not only in Sodom, but in Lot's very home that is being revealed. Indeed, the Midrash Tanchuma is shocked. A father, the Midrash says, is supposed to protect his children. And here he's willing to give them up to be abused? Something is awry in that home. And so the Torah offers a critique in the form of blindness, a metaphor for the blind eye that we turn when we don't want to confront something terrible, even abuse, that is right in front of us. Recently, a friend described her terrible experience of domestic abuse. She told me the story after she was finally able to break free and leave. The abuse happened behind closed doors, where no one could see. And yet, she explained, there were signs that we ignored. "I have lived in this religious community my entire life," she told me. "I'm smart and accomplished, a self-defined feminist, but I did not have the courage to tell anyone. I didn't think anybody would believe me. I didn't go to the police because I didn't want to create havoc and unrest for my children. And there was a pandemic, and so I kept quiet. But she said there were signs, and no one asked. There were signs, and I didn't ask. Why was she leaving her home in such a hurry? Why did she seem anxious and nervous? I should have asked, but I was blind. Blind because we tell ourselves abuse does not happen here, in this community." In our story, the Mefarshim generally agree that the men of Sodom were not physically and eternally blind, but they were metaphorically blinded. An array of interpretations on the word sanbeirim, the word for blindness, were offered. For the Ibn Ezra, it was a blindness that was mechashecha ayin v'halev, that causes a darkening of the eyes and heart. It is the blindness of ambivalence, where one can see reality, but the heart is hardened. We close our eyes and our inaction allows abuse to continue. Rashi has two interpretations. In our story, sanbeirim is understood as makot ivarun, a reference to being blinded with a light or a blind spot. It is a blindness that you can see everything else clearly, but are blinded by the charisma of the accused abuser. Perhaps they are a communal leader or an upstanding member of the community. The light of the abuser that the abuser shed blinds us to the destruction ensuing right in front of our eyes. Rashi has another interpretation. In the story of Elisha the prophet, in Malachim Bet, Elisha prays that God should strike his enemy with blindness. The same word is used. And there Rashi explains, sanveirim chole shel shamamon. Blindness is a sickness of confusion. One sees, yet does not know what he sees. A confounding blindness where you know what is happening, but you don't know what to do, what to say, and how to help. Domestic abuse is real. An average of 24 people per minute are victims. And anecdotal evidence suggests that there has been an increase of domestic abuse during the pandemic. And so it's time for this community to take a reckoning. We have to get back to seeing, to the experience of Vayisa Avraham et Einav, Vayar, of lifting up our eyes and confronting that which is right in front of us. We must do so first by recognizing that the problem is right here in our backyards, then we must educate ourselves on the facts. Abuse is often about control and comes in many forms: financial abuse, sexual abuse, physical abuse, and emotional abuse. Then we must recognize the many variable signs of control, of forced isolation, of public insults, of fear and erratic behavior in victims. And finally, we must have the courage to ask, to not be silent when we see something awry inside our friend's home. Please know that I am trying, learning, and growing. If you are struggling or know someone who's struggling, there are resources. Contact one of the rabbis, a mental health professional, or someone you trust. I've also posted organizations that can offer help and support. This is a heavy topic on what feels like a very heavy Shabbat, but I hope we can help one another cure ourselves from this communal plague of blindness and learn once again to truly see.